Photography have been in and out of our studio. Thank you all. Well, I just want to start. We're going to have a kind of loose conversation, and we're going to follow with a Q&A. And then I do want to say, too, that Martin will be in the gallery, able to talk about individual works floating around if you have additional questions. We're going to shoot to do about 25 minutes in here. And we're going to start out by just talking about your childhood and how you became interested in art. Martin's from New Orleans.
Well, my orientation is visual. Mostly visual. I knew that when I was four, and very early on, I expressed myself through visual means. I tried drawing the people and things around me, and I was inspired by what I saw. So, as I taught for some 40 years, I realized that there are a number of different learning styles. You know, there's the kid who's like this, who's always in trouble in class. You know, and that's someone who is kinesthetic. You know, they learn by moving, by experiencing, by touching, by doing things. And then there are people who do that best with their ears, and they at the top they become musicians. And, you know, the kinesthetic, you know, dancers, athletes like that. The conceptual, the people who are more about the conceptual model, writing something like that. But for me, it was visual, so I never really had. Well, that was, you know, I was born in the South, so you know, athletics is kind of next to godliness, and you live in Louisiana, so yeah, that was silliness.
So you went to Xavier, didn't know you were
going to
study art until people pushed you.
Then
what changed?
Yeah, I spent time, I didn't plan to go to college. I really wanted to join the Navy because a friend of mine who graduated a year before me did that, and I thought, well, I'm not interested in college, maybe I'll do that too. Well, I couldn't get, my parents wouldn't sign, so, and the high school I went to, graduation requirement was that you did an application for college. So I had to, so I did that. And I was accepted, to my surprise, at Xavier. So we're sitting there with the rest of the freshmen in orientation, and people are saying, I'm majoring in this, I'm majoring in this. I had no idea. But, you know, my buddies were like, well, you know, you're always drawing in math class, so. Maybe you should check out the art department. And went to the art department, and there was John Scott. So.
Does everyone know John Scott?
Yeah.
His work is just on the other side of this wall. But tell us a bit about your relationship with John.
Well, we lost him in 2008. But John Scott was a creative and intellectual genius. He received the MacArthur Genius Award. The things he did were just incredible. He was a sculptor, he was a printmaker, he was a painter, he could draw, he could cook. I mean, we have bread parties where he would literally braid the dough, you know, to make these beautiful loaves. I mean, he did everything. He spoke about living in a spherical realm. He imagined himself being at the center of this huge sphere, and the skin of the sphere was covered with a bunch of points, and those points were all of the things that you could aspire to or want to make contact with, all of the different disciplines and everything. And the beauty of that system is that every point is the same distance from you. So you literally had access to everything. So that's the kind of thinking that John Scott did. He taught me and all of his students to run to your mistakes, because that's where the learning happens. Mm-hmm. To examine things that didn't go well until you understood what it was that you know, that you were missing. So, I could talk about Scott all night.
Well, Well, you did painting for a long time. Would you characterize that as not going well?
Yeah, I would.
So you tell us about you did that in undergrad and grad school, and then maybe how you got to welding.
Well, I thought, like many people, that art was painting. So my undergraduate degree and my graduate degrees were both in painting and drawing. I was really a lousy painter. I wanted to go right to the surface. I wanted to go right to that surface, and it just didn't work. I didn't realize until after years of making sculpture that painting is a construction as well. So there are layers of things that you have to take care of with that. You can push. I just sort of push the material around, and you can push painting materials around, but you just went. So, Scott, when I came back to Xavier to work with Scott, I was reintroduced into sculpture. First through casting metal, he built the foundry. There was no foundry at Xavier. He tapped into the school's gas line and got fire bricks and put the fire bricks up and came with fiberfax inside of that. And connected, welded a pipe to a hair dryer, and instead of a bellows, So he had this genius that allowed him to take things that were intended for a completely different purpose, and employ them to do something else. And that's powerful in itself. But one day he was going to Blazer Steel to get some sheets of metal to do his sculpture. He asked me to take a ride. So I took the ride, and we got to the steel yard, and I see these I-beams there. And to me, the I-beams look like a piece of charcoal this big around that you could make a line with in real space. Because a part of what I was dissatisfied with about painting was that it was flat, and that you were creating illusions of space and illusions of forms, and I wanted to work with actual space and form. So that's what got me involved in sculpture.
So I know you were pushing yourself to do painting for a long time. For a long time there was pressure. Maybe not. There was this idea that African American artists should be doing figurative work. How did you kind of escape that, or how have you tried to escape? Those categorizations.
I don't know that I escaped it, because I tried it for a long time. Actually, I went to grad school because my teachers put a book in front of me called Images of Dignity. It's a book about the work of Charles White. And when I saw that stuff, I mean, he made this beautiful image of African Americans and the heroic figures like Harriet Tubman and all that. As well as regular folk, and they had so much dignity and beauty, gravitas, and I just wanted to be a part of that. I wanted to express some of that myself. So I got to Otis, but when I met Charles White, and saw the power of his personality, I realized that work came from that personality. From that gut, and it was different from mine. So then I realized I needed to find my own voice, and it took me a while. I mean, 5 years after I left grad school,